Hi, here is my story. Part one, night in white pants. I moved back home and it was very nice to reconnect with old friends. One night I went out with one of my best friends. We went to the Turkish Cultural Center for a quite unusual experience. It was the celebration of end of Ramadan. So there we were with all these women who had been fasting, and they explained that the reason to fast is to be able to appreciate what you have in your life. You deprive yourself. I have never fasted, but I could relate to deprivation of love, attention, sex. And then they were giving thanks for everything that they had in their lives. And it reminded me of how several years ago I was going to visit home and I was going alone with my two kids. At the time, I spent a lot of time alone. My husband was coming back home late. He was working a lot and I was practically a single mother. What I'm trying to say is that on that trip, I remembered about that man who we made out with like 10 years ago. He was always there somewhere on the back of my mind. I could never forget him. I touched myself and I actually wept after I climaxed. I was grateful that he was there for his existence. Anyway, nothing happened between us that time during that trip. But now here I was back home and we started talking again and he invited me to his show. He was an artist, a very special one, very inspired and inspiring. I teased my hair. I put on some makeup. How's that? And there is where the white pants come in. I wore my white pants because I call them my bootylicious pants. So I entered the room and we saw each other right away, and then we were aware of each other the whole time while he was on stage and I was in the crowd watching. And then I decided to go to the bar that was about 20 feet away and made sure to bend just enough for him to admire my beautiful, seductive behind, which I'm sure he noticed. And then I walked out to stay sufficiently mysterious. And I enjoyed the night outside. The moon was beautiful. The night was warm. Then when I was about to head back in, he was there at the door and there was no running away from him. So we talked. We talked about art and many things. At the end of our conversation, he leaned over and said, "You're beautiful." Then we hugged and went on to our separate ways. The next day, we kept messaging each other. There was no restraint this time. We just kept talking and talking, and if sometimes he wouldn't reply right away, I felt like a junkie deprived. I kept checking my Facebook and, you know, seeing if he saw the message and if he's planning to reply, thinking that maybe I said something wrong, maybe I shouldn't have said that, and then when he would reply, it would be like an explosion inside me. I would be so happy, and then I would reply but not right away. Also, wait a little bit to make him a little suffer a little. And then it just kept going on like this. And so eventually I told him that I had made a resolution to write things down. I wanted to write a story about myself. And I wanted to pour that energy I have inside me into something creative. He thought it was a great idea. And he suggested... a reading group. So, like, we have to invite other friends. But then he added, that reply just sent me onto a frenzy of rapid masturbation. He wanted to see me. I really wanted to see him. I kind of couldn't believe he said that. A few days later, he texted me asking if we could go for a drink, and I said yes. Maybe I should have said no, couldn't say no. Maybe I should have said nothing, or I should have said goodnight. Of course I said yes. I couldn't resist his attention. There it was, the moment of truth between me and my husband. By the time we had resolved to be in an open relationship and just be honest with each other and do what we have to do. It seems there was no other way. So I told him that I was going to get a drink, and it was pretty late at night, and he said, fine, just use a condom. I'm just going to get a drink. Anyway, he reminded me that the next day I had to work and that I should be careful, and I said, fine, bye. And I just left. I didn't do anything about my hair. I didn't fix my makeup. I didn't even change. I was wondering why. And I knew this is because I was going to see him, and there was nothing that could stop me. This is part two. I don't have a title for it. I walk into the bar where we agreed to meet, and there he is. It's him. We hug, and our bodies just fit perfectly together. And then we talk, and we had to leave the bar because it was about to close. And as we were crossing the parking lot, all this nervous energy was pulsing through me, and I just kept talking. I kept talking, I couldn't stop. I was trying to explain myself, and it's like you wait for something for so many years and you think you know how it's going to go, and then when it happens, it's just not like that. And you don't know what to say, and it's not what you expect. He also told me about his girlfriend of 17 years, and at some point he said, you know, maybe we should call it a night. I blew it. That was it. Blah, 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 blah. He was going to walk away. And I couldn't let him, because after all these years of this, it was like it was almost in my hands, and now I had to let it go. I couldn't let it go. I should have just let him go, but I couldn't. And I told him, get into my car. And he did. So we were in the back seat of my car, and it was kind of hot inside, and we were close, and we just started making out. I can't believe this is happening, I thought through erotic hate. I leaned over and buried my face in crotch. And then I fucking bone you completely. But then, so, I'm on a fire. This man goes down as a true.
work of art, a collaborative masterpiece between surrender and restraint, between him and me.
And then you stopped me. Stop me. What? It was a mistake. I don't want to do it. It's not you. I don't want to hurt my relationship. You knew what you were doing. You made a grown-ass woman come out here, and you knew that I was married, and you knew that you weren't free. Why did you invite me here? I was so mad. I was so mad. I followed him out of my car and into his car, and I shouldn't have done it. I shouldn't have done it. I should have just let him go and be free and keep my dignity and everything, but I couldn't take it. I was so mad out of my mind that I went after him and I got into his car and he said I wasn't welcome there and it was his girlfriend's car and I really should get out and... It all ended with a civilized hug. He told me that I was amazing and that it wasn't me. My husband also tells me that I'm amazing. I wonder what they mean when they say that. I got out of his car and I went over to my car and drove home. And the next morning I got up, got dressed, put my makeup on, got my kids ready for school, drove them to school and went to work. Very well adjusted. I guess we all walk around with holes in our egos and hearts. The trick is you can still walk. It was a dream that never came true. Time passed and I didn't need you anymore. And one day I woke up realizing maybe I don't have to need anyone. Maybe I am enough. And for that I thank you.
This is a song for the ladies. But fellas, listen closely.
You don't always have to fuck her hard. In fact, sometimes that's not right to do. Sometimes you got to make some love and fucking give her some smooches too. Sometimes you got to squeeze. Sometimes you got to say please. Sometimes you got to say hey. I'm gonna fuck you softly. I'm gonna screw you gently. I'm gonna hump you sweetly. I'm gonna ball you discreetly. And then you say, hey, I brought you flowers. And then you say, wait a minute, Sally, I think I got something in my teeth. Could you get it out for me? That's fucking teamwork. What's your favorite position? That's cool with me. It's not my favorite, but I'll do it for you. What's your favorite dish? I'm not gonna cook it, but I'll order it from Zanzibar. And then I'm gonna love you completely. And I fucking fuck you discreetly. And then I fucking bone you completely. But then I'm gonna fuck.